Okay, well, my character, Ted Wallace, is a failed and embittered poet who's a drunk who has become a theatre critic, which he hates doing, and at the beginning of the film, he gets the sack. And he goes to... He gets employed by a kind of niece, really, who thought she was dying of leukemia, but thinks she's had a miraculous cure. And the cure happened at a country house called Swafford House, where an old friend of his lives, and one of his sons is Ted's godson. And she employs him to go and find out if the miracles are really true. And this is what he sets out to do, because he doesn't believe in miracles, and he sets out to prove they're wrong. And without giving too much away, I guess he learns something and to an extent gets his comeuppance.
We're working with a fantastic cast, particularly the young Emily Barrington, who is in many ways the catalyst for the story, and a wonderful young director. Can you talk, I guess, about specifically working with Emily and John?
Well, I'd never worked with Emily or John before. John had been wanting to get the film made for 10 years, so it's been a huge, long process for him, getting the script done and all that, and it's hugely to his credit that he persevered with it. Emily's just lovely. I mean, I didn't work with her a great deal, actually. We had, I think, a day together and just got on very well, and it was very, and had great fun. Well, it's great that a film can open, and by opening, it can do an event like this that supports two such great charities. I think that's wonderful.